everyone. We're here today in Singapore at the first day of the Singapore Fintech Festival. All I can say is, wow. There are 60,000 people due to attend, five giant halls full of different companies, fintechs, regulators, central banks, absolutely incredible. We'll be hearing later on from the various people that are here with us from Luxembourg. We have quite a large contingent. We're here at our booth, sponsored by Luxembourg Finance, and the team is here ready to go into action to find the greatest and best companies to help solve the problems for the Luxembourg community.
So I'm here with Philipp from Luxembourg for Finance. He's been here for 2 days. How's it been going?
Well, so far it has been fantastic. The place is packed. We have about 60,000 visitors here. We are doing a great job at the stand here. So I'm very excited being here. And so far, I'm very, very satisfied about the turnout. My highlight so far has been to meet a lot of different fintechs who take really an interest in our ecosystem. And we have our fintechs who are here and who have made great contacts, some deals, and are dealing on partnerships.
Great to be here in Singapore. I'm Alice Danoy. I'm leading the Cube KPMG in Luxembourg. So the Cube stands for KPMG Hub for Entrepreneurship and Innovation. That's the reason why I'm here this week, to get to know the ecosystem here, to get inspired with what's happening in Asia and how the fintech world is evolving, and to bring all those good ideas to our clients in Luxembourg.
As much as Luxembourg and Singapore have many things in common, as Singapore is the regional hub for ASEAN or the wider Asia region, Luxembourg is a hub into Europe. So we are both in our own respective roles bridge builders. So it is for us quite natural to be here, to be presenting and talking to both the organizers and the fintech participants.
Hi, I'm Luc Falempin, I'm the CEO of Tokeny.com. We are a tokenization platform based in Luxembourg, and we are here today in Singapore to meet other financial institutions, fintechs, and to make some business in Asia, as Singapore is a big hub for finance. So far, it's probably the biggest event for finance I've ever been in 2 years, a very big event. We work a lot because it's very big, but some good business opportunities.
Hi, my name is George Bock from governance.com. So basically what we do is what our name says, governance, but we do digital governance, so efficient compliance governance for financial institutions. Singapore, of course, is a place that is very interesting for us. Governance is a topic also here in Singapore, efficient governance also. What is interesting here is the international character. Every country is here represented, and you have a very good outlook on what is going to come next in this industry, and more specifically in the finance industry. And one thing is sure, you should become digital very soon.
My name is Ian, founder and managing partner of Ekofolio. We call ourselves a mission-driven fintech company, enabling forests globally to be investable and liquid. It's been a pleasure to come back to my own country because I'm Singaporean. It didn't feel like we missed this for the world, right? This is the first time I've seen Singapore look at financial inclusion and sustainable and climate finance. So I kind of felt like I had to be here.
Hello, Pascal, I'm the CEO of Neterium. Neterium is a screening API. Why Singapore? Because the financial technology domain in Singapore is absolutely extraordinary, in the sense that I've seen over just a few days an enormous amount of payment platforms, money transfer platforms, and they all have this KYC need. They are all sophisticated technology actors, so they're looking for an API.
Nigel, Verdon, the CEO and co-founder of Railsbank, a friend of Luxembourg House of Finance, who we actually have a desk there. Well, why am I in Singapore? Railsbank has just launched in Singapore. I now live here. And if you saw the Sing Life launch of their debit card with infrastructure behind it.
My name is Waleed, I'm the founder and CEO of Paysky. Paysky is a payment solutions provider with a vision of democratizing e-payments. Basically, we enable financial institutions, businesses, and consumers remit, pay, and get paid. In a very challenging market like the Middle East and North Africa, where bank population is very low, we needed unconventional, innovative solutions to approach both consumers and business and bring them to the financial ecosystem. We're here in Singapore Fintech Festival this week to explore possible synergies with other fintechs in the region for possible collaboration on cross-border payments.
I'm Simon, Simon Skov from Copenhagen Fintech. Copenhagen Fintech is the kind of the fintech community organization in Denmark, a bit like the last in Luxembourg. We're here at Copenhagen Fintech with a delegation of 20 startups and also 10 other companies, so we're 60 persons in total. So far this is our largest delegation. But that's part of what we do in Copenhagen Fintech. We help startups grow, scale, and taking them here is part of the scaling journey where they're meeting international investors, meeting international partners.
Singapore Fintech Festival, it's over. It's been an amazing journey. I think I never met so many people in my life. Tens of thousands of people stopped at our booth. Finished all my 500 business cards in a few hours. The whole world of fintech is here in Asia. The world of finance is shifting, but what I've discovered personally is also shifting towards Asia. More and more those companies are running the show because they do have the mass, the volume to do business. They do have a lesser compliant way to do business. So of course they more fast than us and more efficient than us. So for sure, the LHoFT will come back next year.